Start again. My name. My name.
Be yourself, dude. Yeah, yeah. Be yourself.
No, but I'm missing because there's three prompts or four prompts.
Yeah. So this time you only have to say three. So say your name, ethnicity, and then how long you've been incarcerated. Okay.
My name is Jimmy Kashi, and I am of mixed descent. My mother is from the island of Saipan in the islands of Micronesia. My father is Japanese from the prefecture of Kamakura in Japan. I've been incarcerated for 10 years since 2007, March. I would like to share the fact that my incarceration has definitely led to transformation in myself that I never could have made possible without the experience of incarceration, the traumatic loss of freedoms, and my quality of life have led me to reanalyze and self-evaluate everything that I have gone through post or pre-incarceration. My life in the streets, I was never a wild one, but granted, I am here in prison. I have made several attempts at being sober, drug-free in my life, and it took me to be incarcerated to really, really, truly be free of drugs. It's an amazing transformation, and I shock myself, and I wish one of the biggest regrets that I have in my life. My biggest regret in life is that I could not have done this without incarceration, because the change that I've experienced in my life has been absolutely amazing. And it's sad to see that I am thriving in prison in a way that I could not do out in the free world. Life for me inside of prison is very routine. 5 days a week, I wake up at 6 in the morning, get ready, go to work. I eat breakfast at work, and I get on. I start my duties at work from 6:30 to 2:15. From 2:15 to 3:15, I'm up here at the club when I'm expected to be up here, and we do a club work to ensure that our club is running as efficient as it can be. After that, I go to the yard for about 30 minutes, get some exercise, and then go back into the unit and just repeat the day. Often my life is broken down into seasons. And right now we're going into the fall season, which normally is a very busy time for me due to our club events and just the overall timing of the year. I am, through being a club member initially first, Johnny proposed the idea of creating a garden in the penitentiary. And this has been a long, ongoing project, and since the seed to now, I eventually inherited a executive body position in our organization, which includes me in some form or fashion in the day-to-day operations in collaboration with the dream of the garden. Repeat that again.
Why do you want to see the garden happen, or what do you feel like the garden would do for you?
I want to see the garden completed because it enhances the quality of lives of the people that are incarcerated. And people that are incarcerated, and there are people who desperately need a change in the quality of lives, because this is a concrete and steel building, an environment. Putting some trees, some water features, a location that can provide some people to decompress, or even just it's like looking at a fish pond, an aquarium. There's absolute facts that lowers your blood pressure. So I think having a garden in our environment would definitely enhance the quality of lives for those living here and those who are working here. There's a very, very big, there's a large population of individuals here who have mental health. Some lighter than others, and some more severe than others. I personally have a brother who's in the inmate management IMH, management unit. He's on 22-hour lockdown every day. And if I could make this garden project a reality, I know that they can absolutely use that that space.
Anything else you want to share about anything in general? Anything else you want to say?
This project, I'll be very honest. I was a very big, very, very big skeptic. A very big skeptic. And seeing where it's at now has definitely shown me that there's nothing you cannot do if you really put your mind to it. And I think, I think that, you know, being able to provide something for us as marginalized individuals in our societies, you know, people might say, oh, why are they spending $100,000 on a garden? You know, when we're inmates. But I think, no, I know that if this garden was to be completed, it would be very monumental, the first of its kind in the United States. And I think that would definitely help me, would help everyone, would help the workers. I think it's about expanding your quality of life. And I think it'll definitely, I know it'll definitely help me. It'll help our community. And I really want to be shown that this is possible. And as a skeptic, now a believer, that it's possible. I'm really looking forward to seeing this come to fruition. My name is Jimmy Kashi, and I've been incarcerated since March of 2007. I am of mixed race. My mother, who I love very much, is from Saipan. It's in the Pacific Islands, Western Pacific Group Chains of Micronesia. My father is Japanese from the Honshu Island Prefecture of Kamakura.
Perfect.